Good afternoon, all of you. Welcome to the orientation session on National Innovation and Startup Policy. And I welcome our dignitaries, Professor Dr. Bimal Sarangi Sir, Principal of Rajdhani Engineering College and President of IIC. I also welcome Professor T.P. Satpathy, Basic Science HOD and Coordinator of ARIA. I welcome all the faculty members, all the HODs, all the students. So this session is basically organized to make you aware about the National Innovation Startup Policy. Before starting, let me introduce you to the IIC cell. In the year 2018, the Ministry of Education through MoE Innovation Cell launched the Institution Innovation Cell, that is IIC program, in collaboration with AICT for higher educational institutes to systematically foster the culture of innovation and startup ecosystem in education institutes. Primarily, IIC's role is to engage large number of faculties, students, and staff in various innovation and entrepreneurship related activities, such as idea, problem solving, proof of concept development, design thinking, IP and project handling, and management at pre-incubation and incubation stage, so that the innovation and entrepreneurship ecosystem gets established and stabilized in the higher education institutes. So today's program is basically aimed to make you aware about the National Innovation Startup Policies, so that how you can basically model your ideas into a startup. Now I request Professor Dr. Bimal Sarangi Sir to kindly address the gathering. Sir, please.
Hello.
Yes,
hello.
Yes,
yes. Yes. Good afternoon, all of you. On behalf of Rajdhani Engineering College, I welcome you all to Institutions Innovation Council of Rajdhani Engineering College, Bhubaneswar. In fact, this Innovation Council, in fact, video is not working. Okay. Anyway, the basic objective of this Innovation Council of Rajdhani Engineering College is to inculcate the innovative attitude among the students, faculties, and all the stakeholders of Rajdhani Engineering College, so that this innovation practice will work, and the students during their course of studies, in addition to their regular curriculum, regular activities, they will be able to resolve some of the issues which will be observed in the social life, in their day-to-day life, and by their knowledge, by the use of technology, they can find out some method of solution. As the term Innovation Council itself, it is not a big thing. See, every man or woman having certain ideas and knowledge to do work differently. Say, for example, suppose, let us take example of making a small toy from a paper. Say, for example, I will give a A4 size paper to each individual, say a group of 20 students, and I will tell them, use this paper for making a toy. So you will see different people will design or think differently to do some projects using a piece of paper. It may be a small boat, or it may be a small pot, or it may be a small toy, or it may be a small rocket, like this. That indicates every person, everybody is having some different thinking, which is called design thinking. That's when thinking attitude is different and it varies from person to person. And same thing is called also an innovative idea. Innovative idea. The thing is that we are unable to see what we have. What we have. And the major role of Innovation Council is to boost or motivate all its members, all the students, all the faculties to look into their inherent qualities. What is within them? They should see it. They should find it. And that finding will be germinated or it will lead to grow like a product. That is the basic objective. With this objective, we have registered as a organization under Ministry of HRD, Ministry of Innovation Cell, Government of India, AICT, and the HRD Ministry to become the Institution Innovation Council. And in the first objective is to find out, we will motivate the students, we will motivate the faculty to find out the problems which is seen in their naked eye. One small example, another example I'll give. When you are walking on the road or you are sitting in your room, you will find lots of dusts are coming. Lots of dust are coming. And the dust are creating different type of diseases without our knowledge. Now the basic objective or basic problem of society is the dusty atmosphere. Sometimes we found people are shouting that how to reduce that if you will plant maximum of number of trees. That is one solution. Okay, fine. We will plant maximum number of tree. But even then, if dusts are coming to the house, how to protect protection from the dust? So for that, we can instill or we can find some equipment which will be utilized to collect dust inside the room. So how it will collect the room dust from the room? Simple principle is just we can put some vacuum-like system which will suck the dust, and dust can be reduced in a room, and in the room we can safely inhale the air. So this is one method. Similarly, if you'll see in your computer or your mobile, some of the parts which are able to generate heat during the function. You'll find when you can catch your mobile phone for a long time, you'll find it is getting heated. So if it will heat, then what will happen? Definitely some energy is losing from the parts of the mobile, and the mobile life will be reduced. So company, what they used to do, they used to install some other materials which can suck it from the mobile itself, from the laptop itself, from the computer itself, so that the parts inside the equipment will be getting longer life. In the laptops also, you will see some fans they are using to cool the parts when you are using the laptop. In that case, the role of the fan is to strike air into different parts. But if the part is very small, like mobile, you cannot insert a small fan. So what you will do generally, you use to suck the heat by using certain devices. And that devices are nothing but different types of material. Maybe a small piece of aluminium in pure form, if you will put it inside the laptop or inside the mobile, immediately it will collect or extract heat from the part. And that part will reduce the heat of the other part of the body of the computer or mobile, and which is called sinking material, So unless otherwise, we will feel that there is a problem, we cannot think the solution. This is a small example. And thinking material, we may not have idea that a material, how it will sink heat. How it will sink it. When we'll go through the books, say engineering materials of metallurgy or material science, we'll be able to study the properties of different materials. It may be aluminium, it may be copper, it may be any other elements also. Those are having more power to sink or to sucking the heat from the other parts. Why they are so? Because aluminium in pure form is very soft and it can mold it to thin films like surfaces. And that film surfaces will able to get heat from the hotter body to the cooler body by using the laws of thermal engineering or second law of thermodynamics. That means when a body in hotter condition will be there and a cool body is another part, hot or heat energy flows from hot body to cool body because due to the potential difference. Just like if you will store water in a reservoir in higher potential position, then definitely it will flow downstream. That means to the lower potential area. Same thing we can apply here also. That means we will use the laws of thermodynamics, use the material science and our knowledge, our talent to integrate both law and the material to get or to sink the heat from the bodies like laptop or your mobile or any other device. Similarly, if you see the air conditioning room, nowadays we are installing window AC or split AC or any other type AC inside a room. Now the challenge is like this. These window ACs or split ACs, they are using CFC gases, which is highly detrimental to the environment. So the next question is how to reduce the impact of this ACs. And you may think, or this use of heat sink materials without use of your CFC or freon gas or any other gases directly, if you put these heat sink materials in different corner of the room, they can extract heat. By using small fans, we can extract the heat from a room, and in that case your air conditioning principle will be changed. That is the innovative idea. That idea, when you'll conceive into a product and you can patent it, when you'll patent it, you can sell the patent with higher money and you can generate the resources for your livelihood. That is the cycle which we have been planning to inculcate in our innovation cell or innovation council of Rajdhani Engineering Cell. And this is the first oriented session. Similarly, in every week, we are planning to go step by step to again to propagate this idea of innovative cell in our students, with our students and faculties, so that they can think different types of problem and solution methods. And we are also planning to train in different domains, so that when a problem inculcate or germinate in your mind, then you will be able to resolve it by using some technology. Unless otherwise we will be trained on that technology, we cannot design a product. So this innovation council is also planning to bring experts from different domain and train our students. During COVID, we are planning to train our students through online mode also. When you'll come to the organization, we'll train you in offline mode, so that this ecosystem will propagate and it will lead to develop a product. And by this process, if any student or faculty will be interested to start a new industry or a business, we will help them also. This is the basic objective of this innovation council. I hope this is the first interaction with you all, and subsequently we are planning to organize different types of topics of discussion and of course training programs, and all the students will be motivated, they will be boosted to start different types of ideas, to germinate different type of ideas, and to develop different types of products which would be beneficial for the society and for everybody. With this, thank you all for watching and listening me on the first session of our orientation of National Innovation Startup Policy, and I hope this will enjoy more also in this program in the coming days. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir, for motivating the students to work in an innovation way. Now I request Professor Tarini, sir, to please address the gathering. He is the coordinator of ARIA. So, sir, please.
Respected principal of the day and other dignitaries, all students and my faculty members and dear students. First of all, I have to welcome to ARIA section of our college. So what is ARIA? ARIA stands for Autol Ranking of Institutions on Innovation and Achievement. That means based on your innovative projects, your innovative research, some achievements are obtained and that will benefit to you as well as the institution. So what about the ARIA? ARIA, it is a program under the Ministry of Human Resources and Higher Education. The basic things of this ARIA is, it, as for the 20th century, is assigned as or 20th century is significant for innovation. In the simplest term, innovation could be defined as the converting ideas into new and improved products, processes, and services. Innovation is about taking invention to the market by translating scientific knowledge into products, services, and offering for economic growth and social development. Our Honorable Prime Minister of India has declared the foreign decade as the decade of innovation. To unleash the creative potential of every Indian. India has already been improving on global stage in terms of innovation ranking from 86th place 5 years ago to 57th place current year. For India to emerge as a global innovation hub, the youth like you of our country, especially in higher education institutions, needs to play a crucial role to create a sustainable innovation ecosystem. Hence, I guess all higher education institutions should have a comprehensive and functional mechanism to convert research into innovation. This ISSL is one of the part of the mechanism. And what are your achievements? What are your innovations and contribution to the society or to the country? ARIA will take the records. This ecosystem will encourage, inspire, and nurture young students by exposing them to new ideas and processes, resulting in innovative activities in the academic year. ARIA, Autol Ranking Institutions of Innovation and Achievement, is an initiative of Ministry of Education, Government of India, to systematically rank all the major higher education institutions and universities in India on indicators related to innovation and entrepreneurship development among the students and faculty. Fortunately, our institution also takes part in the ARIA activity from the last academic. So what are the major considerations, what are the major implications to become a global leader in innovation and entrepreneurship. These indicators are the assessment of innovation and startup ecosystem in the institution guided by Ministry of Education. Some parameters, some weights are allocated to the innovation and startup ecosystem. The basic parameters are infrastructure and facility to support innovation and startups, awareness activities for promoting idea generation and innovation, promotion of supporting entrepreneurship development, intellectual property generation, technology transform and commercialization, innovative learning methods and the process, and innovation in governance. This ARIA ranking will sustain inspire institutions to reorient their mindset and build the ecosystem to encourage high quality research, innovation and entrepreneurship. ARIA also focus on the quality of innovation and measure the real impact created by these innovations nationally. ARIA also sets tones and directions for the institutions for the future development of making them globally competitive and forefront of innovations. The achievements of the students, faculty, are the achievements of our institutions. And based on these achievements, it will not only benefit to the innovators, or it will not only benefit to the students or the faculty persons, it also benefited to the institutions as well as the society. So it is a systematically rank the institutions and rank the quality of innovation and research. So I think all of you get together to make our institution as a remarkable place in the field of research and innovation and entrepreneurship. You may develop your innovation in throughout your career of studies or after passing your degree. Your achievements also benefit not only to the society, to the future aspirants, and you can also guide them in a successful future. My dear students, studying the course material is not sufficient. If you can develop your internal power of your innovation, because all of you must have some quality of thinking, what the new thing can be done. All of us, every human being must have a certain quality. We can develop it. We are also thankful to our mentor, our principal. He has a lot of ideas. If anybody can take, anybody can share their thinking, not only to their faculty members. So faculty members are the first persons who can guide you in a systematic way. But our principal and our mentors They will also help you to guide you in the proper way. Thanking you. This, I have to close my topic here. Thanking you for your patiently listen about this ARIA program. I will also thank Professor Shraddha Madam.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
They were benchmark of the innovation and research strategies in our colleges. Also, thanks to our mentor, our principal, sir, for the guidance. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for awaring the students about ARIA. Now we'll have a small presentation about the innovation, the innovation startup policy. So kindly see the screen. I will share a presentation to you all, and we'll have an awareness about the innovation startup policy. Okay. So first of all, why we have this policy? So if we have to evolve as a 5 trillion economy, we are aiming then we have to evolve as a global innovation hub. Okay. And as we want to evolve as a global innovation hub, we need to build a self ecosystem which will be self sustaining and self competitive, which will be having great ideas. So for that reason, this innovation policy is very important for us. And the most important thing is that this policy covers all the criteria for students as well as for the faculties. So in this, by using, suppose if you have any idea or if you want to start up anything, so there should be a set of policies which you have to follow, and the institute will help you to follow up that policy, and then you can start up your idea. You can make your idea as a startup. So now let us see about this policy. So basically, in this presentation, we will focus on the entrepreneurship thinking approaches and what are the policy design performance indicators and how you have to develop a result-oriented policy. Okay. So what is actually the innovative cell? What are the things which comes under the innovative cell? So there is Smart Indian Hackathon. There is an Innovative Council. Then there is Atal Ranking of Institutes, that is ARIA. Then we have National Innovation and Startup Policy, which has been started since 2019. It was inaugurated in 2019. And there are different type of hackathons which is conducted to make you prepare for this policy. Now, understanding about the framework of this entrepreneurship, innovation, economic development. So there are different type of innovative types, then entrepreneurship traits, then entrepreneurship economic growth, then unleashing entrepreneurship and startup development phases of requirement. So these are the frameworks which is required for the innovation startup. So actually, what is the meaning of entrepreneur? Okay, the word entrepreneur comes from the French verb entreprendre, okay, which means to undertake. And it was this concept first came in 1723. Then in 1819, again, Alfred Marshall, he added another word to this entrepreneurship, that is leadership. So leadership is also required for becoming an entrepreneur. Then there were different type of manifestations which were added for the entrepreneurial changes. The first is introduction to new goods and services, then introduction to new method of production, opening new market, exploitation of new source of supply, in re-engineering organizational of business management process. So finally, the proper definition of entrepreneurship was available in 1985, and it means it can be defined as not merely the creation of a new organization, and also it includes any individual who starts a new business venture is an entrepreneur. So entrepreneur and businessman are two different persons. You should know what is a businessman and what is an entrepreneur. Entrepreneur means there should be an innovation in your idea, in your startup. Okay. So what are the characteristics of an entrepreneur? So you should have motivation. Okay, so you should have motivation, you should be energetic, and you should be hardworking to start up any entrepreneurship activity. You should be creative. You should not do any copy paste. You should always be creative. See, any idea or any startup works only if that idea is creative and if it is new. Then you should always be ready to have a risk-taking ability. Okay, means whenever you start anything, there is always a chances of risk. So you should be capable enough to calculate that risk. Then next is locus of control. So you should, the very important thing, this artist important piece that you have to keep in mind when you are becoming an entrepreneur. The first one is people policy stakeholder. Okay, so it was launched online and all the activities of this NISP is always available online and it will be uploaded also online. So you can avail it. So COVID will not bar you from doing any innovation. So these are the highlights of the policy. And the first is creation of the innovation fund. First, you have to create a proper fund. Then academic break of the semester. Okay, so credit for working on innovation, prototyping, business models. So on this, you have to work. So now we have come to the end of the session. And I would like to now go to the validatory session. So I would like to thank all the students, faculty members, all the HODs of various departments for participating in this program. I would also like to thank our beloved principal sir, Professor Dr. Bimal Sarangi sir. He is also the president of IIC. He was the key motivator for conducting this program. I also thank Professor Tarini Sadpathy. He motivated me and he also helped me to conduct this presentation. So thank you, sir. Thank you all. Hope we'll join soon. The students, those who have not done the registration, a link has been provided, and the faculty members also. Kindly register if you have not done the registration through the given link. So I'll share the link in the chat box.